Ông quý chó. Ông nhân dân đã phát bằng to cái trong đoàn cả này tế vị thi xã cả, xã mạng cả này thay ni. Ông nhân dân đã phát xã mạng cả bằng to sẽ đọc cho khách cầm xã xây đề miền hà dân niêm pi thi đề vật dù bùm buồn rồi đọc bùm bầy mình chóm. Hai nâng miền ដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋធម្មនុញ្ញបំរុងមួយរូបគឺពីទី CCP 300 ឡើងជាសមនការកញ្ញាជាទីហងឡារីការពីស្ថានភាពវត្តមានអវត្តមានភាគីនៅបុគ្គលដែលអញ្ជើញឲ្យចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចសមនការសមនការថ្ងៃនេះសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសម្រាប់សវនការនៅថ្ងៃនេះក្រុមជីកាត់សម្គាល់ឃើញ រដ្ឋភិគីទាំងអស់នៃរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានលើកឡើងតែមេធាវីប្រចាំការសម្រាប់លោកខៀវសំផនគឺលោកខាវិនសនដឺសនិងមកយឺតបន្តិចនៅព្រឹកនេះដោយឡែកលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រោមសាលសវនកម្មនេះដោយលោកស្នើសុំអ្នកបង្សិតមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ទីបន្ទប់សវនកម្មលិខិតអ្នកបង្សិតរបស់លោកនួនជាបានប្រកល់ដល់ក្រុមជីរួចហើយសាក់សីដែលនឹងត្រូវមកផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មបញ្ចប់នៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺមានរហស្សនាម
ពី TCWU 911 ដល់8លោកនិងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាលោកមុំរដ្ឋាមានវត្តមានរួចហើយនៅបន្ទប់សវនកម្មនេះនៅថ្ងៃនេះដែរមានដើមបណ្ដឹងរបស់ប៉វេនីបំរុងមួយរូបដែលមានរហស្សនាម PTCCP 300សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានបាទអរគុណកញ្ញាជាស៊ីហងជាដំបងនេះអញ្ញាមរិះសម្រេចលើសំណើសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលជាមុនសិនអញ្ញាមរិះបានទទួលលិខិតសូមរិះបងសិទ្ធចូលរួមសវនកម្មដែល របស់ជំនួយចោតនួនជាចុះថ្ងៃទី2ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2015ដែលបានបញ្ជាក់ថានៅករណីបញ្ហាសុខភាពជាក្បាលជាចង្កេះមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបានមិនអាចផ្ចង់អារម្មណ៍បានយូរនិងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃខាងមុខឲ្យមានប្រសិទ្ធភាពខ្លួនសូមព្រះបងសិទ្ធចូលរួមនិងមានវត្តមានដៃផ្ទាល់នៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃទី2ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2015បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុពិនិត្យសុខភាពជំនួយចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្
ក្នុងឆ្នាំ2015បានកត់សម្គាល់ពីស្ថានភាពសុខភាពរបស់លោកនួនជានៅថ្ងៃនេះថាមានអាការៈឈឺចង្កេះខ្លាំងមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបាននិងបានផ្ដល់អនុសាសន៍ថាសូមអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកនួនជាចូលរួមនៅតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ណការពីបន្ទប់ខាងក្រោមសាលសម្ណការនេះ ឯលើមូលដ្ឋាននេះនឹងយោងតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃប្រធាន៥៦៥នៃប្រធានផ្ទៃក្នុងអវតកអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចូលរួមនៅតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ណការពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្រោមសាលសម្ណការនេះតាមរយៈឧបករណ៍សោទស្សន៍សម្រាប់ជាពេលសម្ណការពេញមួយថ្ងៃនេះប្រកបឲ្យបុគ្គលិកផ្នែកសោទស្សន៍ភ្ជាប់ប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍សម្រាប់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាអាចចូលរួមនៅតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ ខ្ញុំសូមជម្រាបសួរលោកនួនជាដើម្បីមានឱកាសបន្តការតាំងសម្រួលនៃដាល់ចំពោះសាក់សៃរូបនេះ
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. I'll be asking you some further questions this morning. Yesterday, we finished, or I finished with an admittedly complicated question. In respect of something you said before DC-10, I'm not quite sure if you remember the excerpt that I quoted to you. It was about something you said about the betrayal of Sao Pim, Runim, and Heng Samrin to the Vietnamese. I'll read a literal quote first again, just to refresh your memory, and then I will ask you first a few questions about the meeting during which this was said. Literally, you said, and I quote as the Vietnamese, I will move up a little bit. They talked about the Vietnamese coming in because we had a history with Vietnam. It was about, quote-unquote, master tea.
As the Vietnamese entered the country, some Cambodians betrayed the country, such as Sao Pim, Mul Sambat, Heng Samrin, and others by joining the Vietnamese. Sao Pim was arrested and Heng Samrin was able to escape. He fled with 1,500 soldiers. As he escaped for 7 days, the Vietnamese fought into Svay Ring. We realized that we would fail for sure. As we would lose the war, we began to prepare at the cooperatives, districts, and other camps. We dug up the ground to bury salt and rice at all the cooperatives. End of quote. Let me first ask you, Mr. Witness, do you remember saying this to the DC Cam investigator? Do you recall having said this to
him?
គោរពលោកប្រធានជាទីគោរពខ្ញុំនឹងបញ្ជាក់បន្ថែមអំពីសំណួរដែលត្រូវឆ្លើយនេះគឺរឿងរ៉ាវទាំងអស់នេះគឺបាននិយាយក្រៅបាននិយាយក្រៅពីសំណួរសួរខ្ញុំពីរឿងអាងទៀងថ្មដល់ចប់បញ្ហាអាងគ្រឿងថ្មទៅជារឿងពភាសាលេងក្រៅហើយដំណើរការដែលខ្ញុំបានដឹងនិយាយនេះគឺថានៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ 82 បាទផែនការ 82 បានខ្ញុំដឹងបាទមិនមែនដឹងនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ 77 78 ទេហើយបានន័យថាខ្ញុំ
Well, Mr. Witness, I'm not entirely sure whether that is correct, what you say, because at the very same page, for the record, Mr. President, that would be English ERN 007-286-99, Khmer 007-34-112, and French 011-23659. You talk about the meeting during which this particular issue was discussed, and what you are saying about the meeting is the following. You have been asked by the DC Cam investigator questions about In Cham, and the investigator asks you on the top of the English page, you never met her and worked with her? Never. Question, did you know that she was the district chief? And then you answer yes. When the Vietnamese entered the country, she called for a meeting once. Question, who called? The region chief Tarin and Ye Cham. They called for a meeting with all. Question, before the Vietnamese entered? You answer, before the Vietnamese entered. Question, where did the meeting take place? The meeting was at Svay. Meeting at Svay? Yes. At that time, Tarin was the chairperson of the meeting. Now, yesterday, prosecution asked you a question about Tarin, person whom you knew. And the prosecution also discussed the document, S21 document, which seems to suggest that Tarin was detained, subsequently executed in November 78. If Tarin was indeed chairperson of that meeting, and Im Chem was present, you're talking about the Vietnamese entering the country, I would suggest to you that the meeting during which you heard the story about the betrayal was somewhere late 78 or early late 77 or early 78 instead of 1982, as you just said. Would that be correct? Let me first ask you, did you ever attend a meeting in Svay at the time the Vietnamese fought into Svay Ring that was chaired by Rin? Do you recall having attended such a meeting?
ខ្ញុំបានចូលប្រជុំទេប៉ុន្តែក្នុងអង្គភាពច្រឡាត់បានទៅប្រជុំចំពោះមេដឹកនាំទួយប្រធានវរៈធានកងអីដែលគេក្តាប់កម្លាំងតែចំណែកខ្ញុំគឺនៅខាងនីសាទឆ្ងាយគឺមិនបានទៅប្រជុំទេប៉ុន្តែពួកគេទេដែលទៅប្រជុំបាទតែរូបខ្ញុំផ្ទាល់គឺបានទៅទេតែគេមកវិញបានគេនិយាយប្រាំ
Let me, Mr. Witness, read one little excerpt from that same statement from you about that meeting. You're saying, yes, all district chiefs came together. In the meeting, they had a plan. They did not believe us. As for the plan, we knew that the Vietnamese had fought into Svay Ring province. They confirmed this to us. And then you say, I talked on what they told me. When I read this, Mr. Witness, that seems to suggest that you were in fact present at the meeting chaired by Tarin and Im Cham. Is it not?
តើអញ្ចឹងមែនទេខ្ញុំមិនបានទៅរួមប្រជុំជាមួយយាយចែមទេប៉ុន្តែការប្រជុំនោះគឺទីប្រជុំរួចហើយខាងយាយចែមខាងតរិនអីខាងស្រុកខាងឃុំអីទីប្រជុំរួចហើយហើយខ្ញុំដឹងក្រោយដោយសារប្រធានខ្ញុំប្រាប់ ថាគេឲ្យតាមសហការជីស្រះឲ្យជីកន្លែងសម្រាប់ទុកអង្គមបិលព្រោះយើងចាញ់វៀតណាមយើងរត់ទៅជួលព្រៃយប់ឡើងយើងមកយោស្មីនេះទៅហូបអានោះគឺពិតប្រាកដមែនព្រោះធានខ្ញុំក៏បានយាយប្រាប់តែឲ្យខ្ញុំបានទៅប្រជុំជាមួយយាយចែមខ្ញុំមិនបានទៅទេ ព្រោះខ្ញុំមិនទាន់ស្គាល់ឈ្មោះខ្ញុំទាន់ស្គាល់រូបយាយចែមទេខ្ញុំឮតែឈ្មោះថាយាយចែមគណៈស្រុកមិនទាន់បានដែលឃើញរូបគាត់ទេ
Do you have an explanation Mr. Witness, why DC CAM investigator wrote down what I just read to you, coming from you? If it isn't correct that you were in fact present at the meeting, why is it in that statement?
ការគាត់ត្រានេះបែបជាច្រឡំថាខ្ញុំទៅប្រជុំព្រោះខ្ញុំមិនបានទៅប្រជុំប្រធានខ្ញុំគាត់និយាយប្រាប់ខ្ញុំយាយទៅសរុបថាប្រធានខ្ញុំដែលគាត់ប្រាប់ខ្ញុំនោះព្រោះខ្ញុំនៅឆ្ងាយនៅទលីសាបនឹងនិយាយបានលើងមកប្រជុំគីទេពីលើខ្ញុំលើងទៅគាត់និយាយប្រាប់តាមក្រោយហើយនេះមណ្ឌលឯកសារនេះគាត់សរុបយ៉ាងណាគឺខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេ
Let's leave your presence at this meeting for a while. What did you mean when you said to the DC CAM investigator when you talked about the betrayal of the country by Sao Pim and Mul Sambat, also known as Ru Nim and Hing Samrin? What did you mean when you said betrayal of the country?
ត្រង់មាននៃថាក្បត់អីនោះគឺខ្ញុំដឹងតែពីក្បត់ដោយវិធីណាទេបានកាលនោះគឺខ្ញុំបានរត់ចេញទៅនៅចន្ទ្រមបាទហៅថាព្រៃមិនខ្ញុំឆាត់ហើយទីនោះលឺគេនិយាយទីនោះឯងថាពូភូមិភាកបូពាក្បត់ថាហេងសំរិន សោភឹមរហូតគឺខ្ញុំបានយកពាក្យនេះមុនយាយដែលមណ្ឌលឯកសារចុះទៅផ្ទះខ្ញុំចប់ការងារខ្ញុំមកអានេះគឺនិយាយដោយតែស្នេហស្នាលគ្នាជាសាមញ្ញទេដល់កើតមកគាត់បញ្ជូលចេះខ្ញុំមិនដឹងឆ្លើយថាយ៉ាងម៉េចទេហើយការពិតគឺខ្ញុំដឹងនៅកាលឯនោះចន្ទ្រមទេពាក្យទាំងអស់នេះ
Do you recall what the relation was, if any, between on the one hand Sao Pim and on the other hand Ru Nim, also known as Mul Sambat? Do you know whether their respective children had any relationship with each other? I mean a personal relationship.
Dang tha ta kon kon robos puok kwat nang mien tamneak tamnong ptoal khluon ay da re te.
Ba tha reung kon kat nyom mien ru ki nyai prab da ni ke khnyom ban khoeng ke khnyom ban khoeng pit chiek sdeing te pan ki nyai tha ta so phum kat mien kon kamom muoy.
Do you know whether there was in 75 76 77
77 ឬក៏ 78 ឬក៏អីខ្ញុំថាមិនត្រូវព្រោះ
What was the rumor that you heard?
I had
moved on, Mr. Witness, but to ask you whether you knew of any special relationship between the two zones. So I wasn't referring to a personal relationship, but do you know whether there was a special relationship between the East Zone and the Northwest Zone?
ខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេត្រង់ការធានាតំណងពិសេសព្រោះខ្ញុំមិនបានតាមដានហើយក៏ខ្ញុំមិនបានដឹងក្នុងឆាកនយោបាយគឺខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេខ្ញុំដឹងតែដឹកនាំកម្លាំងរូត្រីដើម្បីដោះស្រាយអង្គភាព
Let me read to you an excerpt from someone who also had a, albeit not as senior as you, leading position at the Trapping
Tama
Dam
worksite.
I'm referring, Mr. President, to E3/9060. That's a DC Camp statement of a witness who testified here. More specifically, I'm referring to Khmer page 007-33054, French 011-23-699, and English 007-28-747. Now this person, like I said, came to testify here, but he also talked to DC Cam, and he said literally, I quote, "The friendship between these two zones, meaning the East Zone and the Northwest Zone, the friendship was meant to crush the Southwest to extinction in order to re-establish the revolution." Can you give me your reaction to this particular statement?
Thank you, Mr. President. My objection to this is simply that I think counsel has mischaracterized to the witness who the statement came from. He described him as a high-ranking cadre. This person worked as a guard or a soldier or guard guarding the work site. It's clear from his testimony he had no basis to have any information on the inner workings of the regime. I have no objection to him putting to this, but I have an objection to him representing to the witness that this was a high-ranking cadre, suggesting that he had some inside information about the relationships between zones.
I'm happy to be more neutral about this person, Mr. President. No problem at all. The excerpt that I just read to you, Mr. Witness, came from the DC Camp statement of someone who also worked at the Trapping Tama Dam worksite, and he said that the friendship between the East Zone and the Northwest Zone was meant to crush to crush the Southwest to extinction in order to re-establish the revolution. What is your reaction to that statement?
Look, you might die, Jumpua, but take the Coca Chalai Bamney.
ខ្ញុំមិនបានជាគិតជល់យ៉ាងម៉េចដែរព្រោះពួកកាសមានអំពីការងារដែលខ្ញុំធ្វើគឺខ្ញុំអត់បានជាគិតទេមិនដឹងសម្រាប់ថាយ៉ាងម៉េចហើយសំណួរនេះគឺខ្ញុំមិនអាចឆ្លើយបានព្រោះខ្ញុំអត់ដឹង
Let me at least try to establish whether you in fact knew or know that person. With your leave, Mr. President, I would like to show a photograph of this particular witness. It's on the interface as well.
It's 3/9443,
English page 007-29. 899, it's a photo belonging to person number 42 in the DC CAM report.
គឺជារូបថតលេខ42របស់មជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជាសូមលោកប្រធានអនុញ្ញាត
អញ្ជើញតាប្រញ្ញារងអន្តជាតិ
I have no objection to the photo. The only thing I'm curious about is why we're not mentioning his name. This person testified publicly with his name. So I'm not sure why that's not on the record here.
I was overly cautious. If it's all right with you, I'd mention his name as well. His name is Lot Soy.
Lot Soy
and here's his photograph
hi ni je rup thot របស់គាត
់អង្គជំនះអនុញ្ញាត
I apparently didn't pronounce it correctly
ខ្ញុំអានឈ្មោះមិនត្រឹមត្រូវទេសូមទោស
Lot Soy គឺ Mr. Witness
Lot Soy
ខ្ញុំមិនដែលស្គាល់ទេ
very well
មិនអីទេលោកសាក់សី
I think I can predict your answer to my next question, but I would like to read another excerpt anyway and to you and ask your reaction again. Mr. President, this is E3/9579. It's a WRI from a northwest zone cadre from the transportation section in Khmer. You're in 009-47-282, French 009-74-761, and English 009-70-467. This particular individual in A question 13 and answer says as follows.Question, did you know why the southwest cadres came to replace the northwest cadres? Answer, they had been accused of being affiliated with the Viet Minh Khmer Rouge and the East Zone Committee Chief Sao Kim. These two zones had turned against Pol Pot. According to my observations, the Khmer Rouge was apparently composed of three or four groups. The first group was the Viet Minh, the second group was the nationalistic Khmer Rouge, the third was the Sihanouk Khmer Rouge, and the fourth group was the Khmer Rouge from China, including Pol Pot. End of quote. Would you like to give a reaction to this statement from this Northwest Zone cadre?
Khmer
ខ្ញុំ មិន ដឹង ថា យល់ យ៉ាង ម៉េច ព្រោះ ក្នុង ឆាក យោបាយ ខ្ញុំ អត់ ដែល បាន ប្រឡូក នឹង អាច សន្តាន ថា ម៉េច ខ្ញុំ អត់ ចិត្ត ឆ្លើយ បាន
Nevertheless, Mr. Witness, I would like to read another excerpt to you and ask for your reaction. This time it is an excerpt from the WRI, from the Northwest Zone Chairman of Logistics and Economics. His president, that is E3/9580. Khmer ERN 0095-1906. French 0100-4437 and English 0097-8422. Now this witness, for your information, this individual is talking about someone with the name of Taham. Taham is the alias of an individual called Thong Thot, who testified in July before the Supreme Court chamber, not this chamber. Taham was the adopted son of Runyim and deputy of the zone military general staff, according to this witness. Then the investigator asked the following question, and now I will quote his answer to you fully. Do you know what happened to Taham? Answer 29. Answer. Taham was also arrested. They were arrested together. I obtained information that both divisions of the Northwest Zone had planned to fight back against Pol Pot. But this plan had been leaked through some agents of the center. That was why the military people were arrested. A little down further, another soldier told me of hearing their leaders say in a meeting that if nothing was done about the Northwest group, the zone would revolt like the East zone. So, Mr. Witness, there's another individual in a high-ranking position in the Northwest Zone, still alive today, who testified about a plan of the Northwest Zone and the East Zone to revolt against Pol Pot. What is your reaction?
ខ្ញុំ មិន ថា យល់ ថា ម៉េច ព្រោះ ក្នុង ឆាត យោបាយ ខ្ញុំ អត់ ដែល បាន រៀន សូត្រ ខ្ញុំ អត់ យល់ ហើយ ក៏ មិន អាច ឆ្លើយ យ៉ាង ម៉េច បាន
Fine if you are not if you were not involved into politics, let me go then with your permission to a more practical level, if that's all right with you, Mr. Witness, I would like to read an excerpt from a book. It's a book from Thet Sambat. More particular, it is E3/4202, Mr. President. English page 0075-7532, Khmer 0085-8342, and French 0084-9437. Now I'm going to be reading, Mr. President, an excerpt, but I will not mention the name of this particular person because he has a TCW number, more specifically 2TCW959. But I see the prosecution standing.
Thank you, Mr. President. Before counsel gets to his next excerpt, for the record, again, I want to correct his characterization of the last witness whose quote he read. He described him as if this was a statement from a person who was the chairman of logistics and therefore had direct knowledge of this plan. This witness was chairman of logistics prior to 1975. During the events in question, he worked in a fishing unit in Sector 4, and in the subsequent answers, he clarified that this information, which seems to have been some form of propaganda he heard, came after 1979. So it should not be suggested on the record, it should be clear on the record here that this is not a testimony coming from, this was not testimony from a person who held a high-ranking position about events that occurred that were within his knowledge.
I'm happy to portray this particular individual as a Northwest Song Cadre, Mr. President. I'm sure we will get back to him in a later segment. The excerpt now that I would like to read to you, Mr. Witness, comes from a head of the hospital in his region in Battambang, and this particular person said in an interview, and I quote, that in one of the meetings he attended in Sadao to overthrow Pol Pot, Brunin said secrecy was mandatory because anyone who was found to be part of the plot would surely be killed. DCW 959 said that after receiving instructions from Lunim, he ordered 70 of his men to transfer medicine and medical equipment to store at his division headquarters. Asked by his men the reason for the move, he lied and said they were preparing to make war with Thailand. Rice was also kept in rice mills, and gasoline was hidden throughout Battambang and Ban Thie Mon Chi province. They planned to destroy bridges across the Sankhe River in Battambang to control the west side, where they had stored equipment, food, and other materials. The plan was very big and important, and if we won, things would be good again, TCW 959 said. This particular witness, although not from your sector, so it seems, is talking about storage of food, equipment, rice, in order to assist troops within the Northwest Zone to attack Pol Pot and others. Is that something that you've heard of, storage of rice and equipment for an armed rebellion? Let me go then a little further, a little closer to the place that you were living and residing and working. I would like to read to you an excerpt from a weekly report of Sector 5 Committee. Mr. President, that is E3/178. I realize I only have the English ERN, so I will start with another document also from the zone, that is E3/160. It's a report from April 4, 1977 until April 29, 1977. It's a report dated 29th of May, 1977, and it talks about
the enemy situation. English ERN, Mr. President, 0014-3452, and Khmer 0000, so four zeros, 8497. On 7 May 77, a group of 50 armed free Khmer soldiers came to attack and successfully evacuated 25 people. They burned down our rice warehouse, damaging 40 sacks of rice, and killed one of our cadres. Do you recall in your function, Mr. Witness, events like I just described, which was written down in this report from the Northwest Zone?
The
weekly report that I just referred to, that I speaks about the hitting of rice in Phnom Srok and Prianeta Priya district. Without quoting it literally, it is a report done on the 21st May of 77, so it's a report actually from your sector. While you were at the Trapping Tama Dam worksite, did you never hear Taval speak or anybody speak about the hiding of rice in order to feed rebellion troops?
Now let me let me return to that meeting that was chaired by Taval and Tahung.
A meeting
of which one witness who testified in closed session here said that you were present, something that you denied. Just for your benefit, he talked about a secret plan to arm the Sector 5 mobile unit. The meeting was at Phnom Konh Kleng. The attendees were promised to become, that they were going to be appointed captains if they participated. But the plan was, although secret, not executed. Now, I asked him the question yesterday, why this particular individual would say that you were in fact present. I would like to repeat that question. Why is it that this individual who testified in a closed session would tell this chamber that you were in fact present? What would be his motive? Do you know? Or would you be able to tell us?
My objection is he's asking for speculation from this witness to speak to the motives, whether this witness was mistaken, whether this person has no basis to comment on why another witness made a statement.
បាទក្តីជំទាស់នឹងគឺមានមូលដ្ឋានសំត្រប់ហើយម្យ៉ាងទៀតតែទំនួលនេះគឺជ្រុំដែលទីហើយបានសួរហើយឆ្លើយរួចហើយកាលពីម្សិលមិញសាស័យមិនឆ្លើយតបនឹងទំនួលនេះទេ
Mr. Witness, this individual who testified here in closed session also talked about someone else who attended, according to him, this meeting. A female leading cadre called Mao. Do you recall a female regiment commander or a leading cadre called Mao who worked at the
Traffic
Command
Dam worksite?
Mr. Witness, I think we have established in this courtroom that you were working closely together with
Daval and Tahung,
that you had a senior position in Traffic Command Dam worksite. To me it seems or it is difficult for me to understand that you don't know anything about plans to overthrow DK government. I have to ask you this question. Are you scared to answer questions from me?
If counsel wants to ask the witness if he's scared, I think that's fine, but he shouldn't be characterizing as if it is an established fact there was a plan to overthrow a democratic Kampuchea when this is based on S-21 confessions, gossip, and propaganda from the regime itself. So he shouldn't be representing to this witness this is an established fact when it's anything but that. And then asking him whether he's scared to talk about something that hasn't been established at all.
I did so much my best, Mr. President, not to mention any S-21 documents, let alone gossip. That's why I was referring to WRIs. But let me...
លោកមេធាវីលោកបន្តសំណួរទៅហើយលោកមិនក៏បីប្រើសំណួរសួរទៅសាក់សីខ្លាចភ័យឬក៏មិនភ័យនោះទេអាកប្បកិរិយារបស់សាក់សីរហូតដល់ម៉ោងនេះមិនមានអាកប្បកិរិយាណាមួយព្រួយបារម្ភពីការផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មរបស់គាត់ទេគាត់គ្រាន់តែឆ្លើយបញ្ជាក់ឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់នៅអ្វីដែលគាត់បានផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មជាក់ស្ដែងនៅពេលនេះហើយនឹងសក្តិកម្មដែលបានកត់ត្រាដោយស៊ីឌីខាំកន្លងមកដែលវាមិនត្រឹមត្រូវដោយមិនយក បច្ចៈពុះអង្គហេតុច្បាស់លាស់នៅក្នុងការទទួលបាននៅចម្លើយតបគឺយកអភិលេងសើចនិយាយបន្ថែមបន្ថយក្រៅយកមកធ្វើជាកំណត់ហេតុដែលនាំឲ្យមានបញ្ហាសួរប្រជុំនេះបញ្ហាទី2គ្រប់មនុស្សទាំងអស់មិនថាបច្ចុប្បន្នឬក៏មិនថាអតីតកាលទេមិនសុទ្ធតែដឹងអំពីរឿងហេតុទាំងឡាយដែលកើតឡើងនៅក្នុងសង្គមគ្រប់ជ្រុងជ្រោយគ្រប់ ក៏លោកកលៀតនោះទេយើងមិនជឿថាដឹងទេសូម្បីតែមេធាវីខ្លួនឯងក៏ទំនងមិនដឹងសូម្បីតែអបតកផ្ទាល់នេះក៏មិនដឹងថាគ្រប់ជ្រុងជ្រោយគ្រប់បុគ្គលិកថាធ្វើអីខ្លះរាល់ថ្ងៃនេះប្រហែលជាលោកមិនដឹងទេកុំថាឡើយដល់ទៅរឿងបញ្ហាសង្គមលើពិភពលោកឬក៏ស្ថានភាពសង្គមកម្ពុជាបច្ចុប្បន្នថាយ៉ាងម៉េចនោះសូម្បីតែនៅអបតកទាំងមូលនេះប្រហែលជាលោកមិនដឹងផងទេជាក់ស្ដែងយើងខ្ញុំក៏មិនដឹងថា ការប្រព្រឹត្តការវិវត្តទៅនៅអង្គភាពផ្សេងទៀតក្រៅពីអង្គចម្រើនរបស់យើងតើវាមានការផ្លាស់ប្ដូរឬក៏មានការវិវត្តយ៉ាងម៉េចការធ្វើអីខ្លះឬមិនធ្វើអីខ្លះក៏យើងមិនដឹងដែរអញ្ចឹងគឺមិនប្រើអត្តនោម័តបញ្ជាក់ថាមនុស្សទាំងអស់សុទ្ធតែដឹងនោះទេកម្រិតត្រឹមតែគាត់ដឹងបានហើយ
Well, if I were to witness, certainly I would be afraid, Mr. President.
I would be afraid, Mr. President.
You ignore my request, Mr. President, so I ask it again. Mr. Witness, are you scared?
មិនមានអីទេព្រោះខ្ញុំកាលដើមដែលមានក្រុមជំនុំទៅពិភាក្សាខ្ញុំឯផ្ទះទៅជួបខ្ញុំឯផ្ទះគឺចង់សួរការពិតនៃអាងស្ពាំងថ្មបាទហើយខ្ញុំក៏តែងតែផ្ដល់នូវការពិតដែលខ្ញុំដឹងក្នុងអង្គភាពអាងស្ពាំងថ្មតែប៉ុណ្ណោះ តែរឿងរ៉ាវអ្វីផ្សេងផ្សេងគឺខ្ញុំមិនបានដឹងព្រោះខ្ញុំមិនបានអនុវត្តព្រោះខ្ញុំអនុវត្តតែការងារខ្ញុំដែលខ្ញុំដឹងថាទួនាទីភារកិច្ចនៅអាងស្ពាំងថ្មបាទដល់ការពីដែលនិយាយលេងសាមញ្ញជាធម្មតាមកបូកសរុបដាក់បញ្ចូលគឺខ្ញុំឆ្លើយអត់កើតបាទ
I have finished. Thank you, Mr. President.
ខ្ញុំអស់សំណួរឲ្យលោកប្រធានសូមអរគុណ។មកអនុញ្ញាតផ្ដល់វិធានការជូនក្រុមសហមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកខៀវសំផនដើម្បីមានឱកាសសួរដេញដោលចំពោះសាក់សីរូបនេះ
Bonjour et merci Monsieur le Président. Bonjour Monsieur le Témoin. Je m'appelle.
Somme
Jingrao Chao.